Hello friends, today we will start the last chapter of algebra, which is nothing but complex numbers. You are well familiar with complex number, you have studied complex number topic at 11th standard. Firstly, we have studied the concept of natural number, then whole number set. Then rational numbers, integers, real numbers. And if you take the equation like x square plus 1 equal to 0, quadratic equation, we know that square of any real number is non-negative. So x square is greater or equal to 0 for all x. Okay. Means x square plus 1 is equal to 0 has no solution in R. Has no solution in R. X square plus 1 equal to 0, this implies is x square is equal to minus 1. Means x is equal to plus minus under root of minus 1. X is equal to plus minus under root of minus 1. And square root of minus 1 is not a real number. Square root of minus 1 is not real number. Square root of non-negative number is not a real number, is not a real number. So, if I denote square root minus 1 is equal to I, which is nothing but iota, this is called as complex number. This is known as complex number. With help of this square root minus 1 equal to I, we are going to define new number system, which is known as set of complex number. So what is the set of complex numbers? Set of complex numbers is complex numbers C is equal to, which is denoted by C symbol. It consists of Z equal to numbers of type A plus IB, where A, B are real numbers. A, B are real numbers. And I is equal to square root minus 1. Square root of minus 1. This set is known as set of complex number. For the complex number Z, this is called as real part of Z. Real part of Z. And this B is known as imaginary part of Z. Imaginary part of Z. I can also represent A plus IB, Z equal to A plus IB is represented as order pair AB, order pair AB in complex plane. So this is your Y axis, this is your X axis. If A is here, say B is here, okay, this number AB, point AB represent A plus IB complex number. Okay. Means our XY plane represent complex number set. Complex number set. There is one correspondence between set of complex number and set of order pairs. So this C is again written as order pairs AB, where A and B are real numbers. A and B are real number. Plane representing complex numbers is known as Argand's plane. Argand's plane. Plane XY in which complex numbers are represented by points is known as Argand's plane. So there is one correspondence. So this set is isomorphic to R2 set, R cross R, which is nothing but R cross R, Cartesian product of R with R, of R with R. Now we'll define operations on sets. Operations. So first one is equality. Z1 is equal to say A1 plus IB1 and Z2 is equal to A2 plus IB2. Are equal belongs to C are equal. If I only if A1 is equal to A2 and B1 is equal to B2. Means real part is same and imaginary parts are equal. In that case, we are going to talk about equality of complex number. So two complex numbers are equal if their real parts are same and imaginary parts are same. Imaginary parts are same. Second operation is addition. 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 Okay. So for Z1 equal to A1 plus IB1 and Z2 is equal to A2 plus IB2. Z1 plus Z2 is equal to A1 plus IB1 plus A2 plus IB2. So what is the natural way to add these two numbers? We can add the real parts and imaginary parts. Real parts and imaginary parts. So this is nothing but A1 plus A2 plus I times B1 plus B2. So sum of real parts plus I times sum of imaginary parts. Sum of real parts plus I times sum of imaginary parts. Imaginary parts. Okay. This is nothing but that one. Then addition, subtraction, subtraction, minus. Here there will be minus, minus, minus. Okay. Sum or difference. Sum or difference. Okay. So this is a way of defining addition and difference operation on set of complex numbers. Then product, multiplication. Multiplication for Z1 equal to A1 plus IB1 plus Z2 is equal to A2 plus IB2. What is Z1 Z2? Z1 into Z2 is equal to A1 plus IB1 into Z A2 plus IB2. Will it distribute A1 A2 plus I times A1 B2 plus I times B1 A2 plus I square B1 B2. Okay. So which is nothing but what is your I square? I square, this implies I square is equal to minus 1. I square is minus 1. Okay. So this is your I square. Okay. So so this I square is minus 1. So this will become A1 A2 plus I times A1 B2 plus B1 A2 minus B1 B2. This is a product of two real numbers, which is a real number. This is a product of real numbers, so which is a real number. So we can add that to A1 A2 minus B1 B2 plus I times A1 B2 plus A2 B1 or B1 A2. Doesn't matter. So product of real numbers, product of real powers minus product of imaginary powers. Product of imaginary powers plus I times cross product of real and imaginary powers means A1 B2 plus B1 A2. Is it clear? Here, product of real powers minus product of imaginary powers plus I times sum of the products of cross products, say. Okay. Means real into imaginary plus real into imaginary. So, in this way, Z1, Z2 operation is defined. Now, how we can define division operation? Division. Division. For Z1 is equal to A1 plus IB1, Z2 is equal to A2 plus IB2, this is not equal to 0. Z2 complex number is not 0 if its real part is not 0 or imaginary part is not 0. Imaginary part is not 0. 0 means 0 plus 0i. So either A2 or B2 not equal to 0, then that Z2 is non-zero complex number. 0 equal to 0 plus 0i is 0 complex number. Is 0 complex number. Z1 upon Z2 is equal to A1 plus IB1 upon A2 plus IB2. Now what we'll do here, A1 plus IB1 into A2 minus IB2 upon A2 plus IB2 into A2 minus IB2. Now by definition of product, this is your A1 A2 minus I square B1 B2, I into I square B1 B2 plus minus I times A1 B2 plus I times B1 A2 upon A2 into A2, A2 square, okay, minus I square B2 square, okay, plus now minus I times A2 B2 plus I times B1 B2 A2. So this get cancelled. I square is nothing but minus 1. So this will become A1 A2 plus B1 B2. By taking I outside, I will get B1 A2 minus A1 B2 upon A2 square plus B2 square, since I square is minus 1. So this is nothing but A1 A2 plus B1 B2 upon A2 square plus B2 square plus I times B1 A2 minus A1 B2 upon A2 square plus B2 square. So, in this way, we'll define division. Belongs to C since A2 square plus B2 square not equal to 0 as Z2 is not equal to 0. is non-zero means either a2 or b2 is non-zero, therefore a2 square or b2 square must be non-zero, therefore their addition must be non-zero. So in this way, division operation is defined. Division operation is defined. Then we'll talk about the complex conjugate of complex number. Complex conjugate of complex number. Complex conjugate. For z equal to a plus ib belongs to C. Z bar is equal to a minus ib. Just interchanging sign of imaginary part. Belongs to C is called as complex conjugate of Z. Conjugate of Z. Just change sign of imaginary part. Plus minus. Z equal to A plus IB, then its complex conjugate Z equal to A minus IB is known as complex conjugate of Z. Okay. Properties of complex conjugates. So for Z1 is equal to A1 plus IB1, Z2 is equal to A2 plus IB2 belongs to C. 1 Z1 plus Z2 bar is equal to Z1 bar plus Z2 bar. If I take minus sign here, we'll get minus. You can easily verify those properties. It is not too difficult to verify those properties. Second, Z1 Z2 bar is equal to Z1 bar into Z2 bar. Complex conjugate of product of two complex numbers is same as product of their complex conjugates. Okay. Third, Z1 upon Z2 bar is equal to Z1 bar upon Z2 bar. Okay. So, say proof, say we'll take second, Z1 Z2 bar is equal to, say your A1 plus IB1, A2 plus IB2, its bar. If I take the product, I will get A1 A2 minus B1 B2 plus I times A1 B2 plus B1 A2, its bar, which is equal to A1 A2 minus B1 B2 minus I times A1 B2 plus B1 A2. Okay, 1 Z1 bar into Z2 bar is equal to A1 plus IB1 bar into A2 plus IB2 bar. What will get? A1 minus IB1, A2 minus IB2. Then, if I take the product of those complex numbers, which is equal to A1, A2, okay, minus minus plus, minus minus plus I square is minus 1, right? Plus I square b1 b2. Okay, then minus here I times a1 b2 plus b1 a2. I square is minus 1, so this is a1 a2 minus b1 b2 minus I times a1 b2 plus b1 a2, right? This is your second. I square is minus 1. So from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2 we get 1 and 2 z1 z2 bar is equal to z1 bar into z2 bar. On same line you can verify remaining two properties, that is z1 plus z2 bar is same as z1 bar plus z2 bar. Z1 upon z2 bar is equal to z1 bar into z2 bar. Even though we are writing these properties for only two complex numbers, you can extend it for n number of complex number. Means z1 plus z2 plus dot dot up to zn bar is same as sum of their complex conjugates, conjugate of product of n complex numbers is same as product of their complex conjugates, and so on. So with this discussion, we'll stop today's lecture here. Thanks for listening lecture carefully. Bye bye.